A very good afternoon. You're watching SIG TV. I'm Akanksha Singh with news. Let's begin the bulletin with top headlines of this morning. Sidhu says unique partition museum will boost tourism in Amritsar. Nobody stopped to help Ludhiana pastor for 11 minutes. 60 dead, over 10 lakh affected by floods in Assam. And now let's start with the news. Captain Amrinder Singh led Punjab government has welcomed the launch of a unique initiative to celebrate on 17th August as Partition Remembrance Day in the memory of those ordinary and extraordinary people, particularly from Punjab and Bengal, who lost everything to country's partition. The government will extend all support to the Arts and Cultural Heritage Trust, which is setting up the World's Partition Museum at Town Hall in Amritsar to mark this event on 17th of August this year. Punjab Minister for Culture and Tourism Navjot Singh Sidhu told the museum will contribute significantly to further boosting tourism in Amritsar, which is one of the India's leading religious tourist destinations. The CCTV footage of Saturday's brutal killing of Ludhiana-based pastor outside church revealed that people did not come forward to help the victim even as he lay injured for 11 minutes after the attackers pumped 3 bullets into him. Taking a serious note of the killing of Christian priest in Ludhiana, Captain Amrinder Singh directed the DGP to order a crackdown on elements trying to stir communal passions in the state by indulging in such attacks and to remain on high alert against such forces. Clear skies for the third consecutive day across Assam ensured water rescission from several inundated areas, but over 10 lakh people will remain affected by the recent floods. A total of 1,512 villages in 32 districts are still underwater and 22,837 people displaced from their homes, still taking shelter in 230 relief camps across the state. The affected districts are Dhemaji, Lakhimpur, Biswanath, Darang, Nalbari and many more. According to the State Disaster Management Authority, one more death was reported from Morigaon district on Sunday, taking the total number of casualties to 60. And that's what we have in this edition. Thanks for watching SIG TV.